start to add some little things which are important, because I don't want him having a base at any time. Because when he makes himself physiologically strong, he's going to be like he is now, and that's hard to fight, because that's a strong man. And it's even worse if he can do a deadlift or a squat,
not both.
So he's going to be powerful, so we need to keep that out of the equation. So I'm physiologically powerful, and he's physiologically weak. Yes, we need that, very important. So whilst I'm doing this, I'll take your base away. Whilst I'm doing it, so it's... Don't push his knee backwards, it's too strong. Help me. So whilst I'm doing all of this, as I'm going to come in, before I come in, my right foot will play it out. So just set that edge off his base. So the minute I make a move, he's slightly behind. So add that into your equation now, and now I'm at the point to play the same game, in and in. So I've got this before he's got a chance to become strong. Make sense? So now as Dave tries to lift his head up, his head down. Right, so what can happen then? If when I go under his arm to sweep him, Dave jumps up on his feet like a big tripod. I'll lift you and just jump your feet. Yeah, big spot. So we'll do it slow. Look, I've gone like this. In a minute, so I do the same thing. Remember, just come down here. Remember, don't sweep in here. Don't move it there. Sweeping. Now, you see that difference? Get under him. Steal those last few inches. There. Get your hips as far under him as you can. You feel like you've hardly moved, but it makes a big difference in weight. Especially with the big lads. So I'll go under there and I'll lift you slow there so you can score. So I go under there, I'm going to lift me up to his feet. Well, now what? Because I can't. Look, he's just basing this leg. This leg of Dave's, he's just basing out, and he's not going to go. Right. This hand here, get out of his belt. So you're holding it with both, and pull him in. Job done. But from there to there, pull him in. Right, watch. Lift him as much as you can, he won't go, he'll keep basing. Now take your foot under his foot. See that? Under his foot. Not by his leg, under his foot. Move his foot, move his shin, move his knee. There you go. Hip slower. Same compression. And add that to it now while you're playing around. Because it can be during the fight, the power. See that there? Didn't gain me up, but stopped him doing up. But it might be something that you're doing whilst you're playing. For position. Just think, ooh. That's flicking someone's nads like a quick finger in the mouth. Anybody's doing a street fight, you can. Isn't it? It's just what the hell. So we're looking for this. Any hand here is a bonus, which is cool, because it's what I wanted. But just play that out. Remember you're opening it. Don't push it back. Dave's strong in that direction. With his knee. He's not strong in that direction. Don't rip your mates when you do it. But look, get your hand in deep, open that up, put your feet deep, pull yourself in, get that belt, readjust everything as you need to. Crappy grip's a crappy grip. Well, class judoka will tell you the man with a good grip throws the other guy. Get your grip as you need it. Don't be happy with 20%. You're on 85-90. What Neil Adams said, with the champion, if it's 50-50, don't. Make sure it's right in your favour. Get hold of it, look. So I go for it, and I go under it, and he jumps. Shit, he's not going to go. I keep this elbow down. This left one, down. I don't want it coming out. It's not up, it's down. Blocking the arm. Not the shoulder, the arm. Grab the belt, pull him in. Lift him as high as you can. Under the foot. Under the foot. Take him away, take him away. Back. Make sense? Yeah? Same thing, same sweep. Strong sweep, yeah?